Today I want to get to like the one foundational, fundamental principle that I think more than anything else is an indicator of what kind of marriage you're going to have. And I want you to have a fun, vibrant, exciting, healthy, strong, balanced, all those things. That's my goal for you. If you're not experiencing a healthy or balanced marriage right now or relationship, it's exhausting. It's very painful. It's frustrating. You feel like you can't get things right, or you're walking on eggshells all the time, and there's just this general disagreement and disharmony. That's exhausting. And if you're a sensitive person who has feelings, then this makes you feel anxious and worried and upset and unsettled. It seems like everything in your life sort of turns gray when your relationship isn't doing well. So it's super important that we get this right. And everything in your life is affected by your relationships, especially your dominant relationship or your primary relationship with the person you're dating, engaged to, or are married to. Now, it's super critical that you make this decision that you're going to be committed to each other. If you're married or you're getting married, then you have to just decide that we're not always going to get along perfectly, but we're not going to just give up on each other just because things get difficult. And so there is this decided kind of love that we all need to have, but that alone, that just that will and determination can prove to end up a very exhausting, painful experience. So there's got to be something more than just the determination to stay together. And that's what we're going to talk about in this video, is the one secret to really engage and have the kind of marriage that you want. Vibrant, happy, loving, fulfilling, life-giving, not life-draining. That's what this video is about. The one thing that you need in order to really make it through the years and have a life-giving relationship. Look, this channel is all about you and understanding yourself and the people in your life that you love better by understanding their personality types. But ultimately, the goal here is to end up with a better life. Ultimately, the goal is for you to not only understand these facts in a rational way or a cerebral way, but that also it would improve your relationships and your connections with people. And today, what we want to talk about is one secret ingredient, one necessary requirement for you to have a happy and loving and positive marriage. And that is, you guys got to be friends. You have to work toward friendship. And it always blows me away that sometimes people have better friends out there in the world than they have inside their own home with their wife or with their husband or with their family members. And if we don't make friendship a priority, then we'll just end up living together. We'll just end up in this awkward, uncomfortable relationship. And so the one thing I would say at the beginning of this video is, if you want to have a better marriage, if you want to be more spontaneous and more intimate and have a greater relationship, then you've got to understand that we're supposed to be friends. We got to work toward becoming better friends and treating each other like we're friends. And so we're going to unpack three key characteristics or challenges that we need to understand if we're going to turn our marriage around and get back to being friends again. You know, once you're friends, all talk of separating or all that goes away, because why would I want to leave somebody that is my friend? So let's unpack this information together. My wife Traci and I have been married for over 30 years. And of course, we've had our ups and downs. We've had challenges along the way. We've raised 5 kids and now we have grandkids, and there's been a lot of health problems and issues and job changes and all kinds of normal things that people deal with. But one thing we've always made a priority is that we relate to one another in a friendly way, is that we're kind to each other. We laugh together. We do things together that we enjoy. And I think the main point here is friendship is the foundation. Friendship is why we ended up together anyway. Is, yeah, I thought she was super hot and attractive, but also we just were good together. We just had a friendship together. And that friendship that started in high school just continued on through college until we got married. And here we are, you know, 30 plus years later, and we're still friends. And I think it's easy to lose sight of this as a couple if we're not careful. Is think about how you interact with your best friends, or how best friends should interact. They laugh together, they play together, they tease one another and make fun of each other, but never to hurt each other, never to really pull each other down or to create any kind of pain. We don't want that. Not because it's not the right thing to do, but because we're friends and you don't treat friends that way. Yet the reality is a lot of times in a marriage, people will treat their friends far better than they would treat their own spouse. They would never talk to their friends the way they talk to their spouse. And this can easily become a blind spot for you in your marriage. Is it seems obvious. And when you started, of course, I think you were friends, but over time, you know, the friendship can erode if we're not careful. So let's get back to this fundamental beginning point, is we need to work at being friends with each other. So one of the pitfalls of the common relationship or the normal marriage is we lose sight of being each other's best friend. And so we end up, you know, doing all the things that friends don't do. We bicker and argue and complain. We attack. We defend. And all of these things we do are not building a friendship. They're actually tearing a friendship down. And again, you know, people sometimes treat their friends at work or at church far better than they treat their own spouse. And it just doesn't make any sense. If you want to have a happy life and you want to have a great life, and again, I understand I'm an Enneagram type 7, so my assumption is people want to be happy. But I guess maybe you don't want to be happy. Some people don't. They would rather have drama and crisis in their life, and maybe I guess that's their way of finding happiness. But it's certainly not what I want, and I imagine there's a lot of you guys that don't want that. Like, you wish it was easier. You're looking at me like, Tom, help me make my wife, my marriage, my husband, help me make our marriage easier. Help us to get along better. Well, it's not just going to happen all of a sudden. It's going to take some effort. It's going to take some initiative and a little bit of guidance in, oh, you know, I thought that this was right. I thought that maybe we should try to be more like friends with each other. And maybe you just need to hear an outside person tell you the obvious. Is, are you friends with the person that you're married to? And what would you do if you wanted to be a better friend to that person? You know, imagine a friend comes to you and says, hey, Bob, I want to tell you about this idea I had. I want to tell you about this dream I had. Or this movie I saw, just something as simple as that. Can you imagine them telling you whatever their idea is and you saying, no, I don't think that's right. No, why, you know what? You're just like your mother. But this is the way we treat each other in a marriage. Like, we don't listen to each other like we should. And we react and respond. And sometimes guys, honestly, there's like great big piles of resentment and bitterness that have grown up over the years. Because we don't deal with stuff when we need to deal with it. And then we're very sensitive. And, well, what did you mean by that? Why did you say it like that? And I know what you were thinking. And all of this is just, it needs to be dealt with. It needs to be dealt with. And maybe let's just talk about that in the next point. So here's some practical steps that you might need to take right now in order to make friendship a priority again in your relationship. I'm telling you, if you guys would be friends first, if you'd work on that and move toward just being better together and enjoying your time with each other and not dreading every time they walk into a room or calling, then your romantic life, your intimacy will go off the charts and your commitment will be so much easier if you can work this out. So maybe there is big piles of resentment that some things maybe you need to just go to the Lord and pray about and learn to forgive. There may be some things that you just need to, for the sake of going forward, for the sake of improving your marriage, you might just have to, Lord, help me let that crap go. I just need to offload some stuff and nobody understands, there's nobody to talk to, but okay, so there may just be some stuff that you just have to forgive just for the sake of being able to move forward. But there's probably a few things that maybe we just need to talk about. But see, we're afraid of talking because we don't want conflict, we don't want problems, or we don't want to, you know, poke the bear and make everything all bad again. But it is bad. If you're not friends, it's bad. And so we need to talk. We need to improve our communication with each other. And we need to decide, I need to become a better communicator. I need to be able to share what's going on. You know, one of the needs we all have in a relationship is that the other person is honest and open with us. And some of us are not very open. We keep everything to ourselves. We keep it all locked in for whatever reasons. And it's hard to make friends with somebody who's always upset about something. It's hard to make friends with somebody who never shares anything. But I know you can't share anything because they get upset. We've got to come together. We've got to have some kind of communication if this is ever going to get better. Also, we've got to learn to support each other. Like, I need to be your cheerleader and you need to be my cheerleader. One of the needs we all have in a marriage is for admiration or appreciation. And we're never going to be perfect as a spouse, and we're never going to be perfect at giving admiration and appreciation, but we need to make an effort to do this. In other words, catch your spouse doing something well and praise them for it. Say, you did a great job, or thanks, I really appreciate you taking the time to make this dessert or to pick up that shirt that I asked for. Just a few moments of recognition to say something positive. If your friend did something for you, you would tell them thank you. But you just kind of take each other for granted. We got to stop doing that. We need to be there to support each other, to hear each other, and not be so reactive when something is said. We just need to learn to let stuff go and not pay attention to everything that is said. We got to let some stuff go. And I tell you, sometimes you have to translate what your spouse is saying. Like, they might say something in the wrong way. They say it in the negative way, you know. They might say something like, I don't feel like you ever have time for me. Now, that is stated in a negative way, and the natural response to that is, what are you talking about? Of course I have time for you. Don't you remember last week when I... And so the natural response to hearing a negative statement about yourself is to defend yourself. Well, we got to get better at translating what our spouse is actually saying. Translate it into the positive. Instead of hearing, I don't feel like you spend enough time with me, hear it as a positive. Like, I really want to spend more time with you. Doesn't that sound so much better? I mean, we need to translate from negative to positive and say things, requests, needs in a positive way. But if your spouse doesn't do this well, you got to do a little bit of interpreting and translating. And then, guys, this is just nuclear important to me, is we need to have fun together. When's the last time you and your spouse, or you and your significant other, when is the last time you guys just laughed together? I mean, really had a good time and laughed together, laughed at yourselves. Now, whether that's going to a comedy show or whether it's going on some adventure or a trip, or it doesn't have to be expensive. It just has to be something we both enjoy doing together. Now, it could be horseback riding or riding four-wheelers in the desert. I live in Florida, so it's probably not realistic. But, you know, it doesn't have to be something expensive or something extravagant. But we need to value having fun together. What's a way to bond together, laughing together? And then probably one more thing I would think of is we need a lot of patience and a lot of kindness. We just need to demonstrate more patience. Rather than just hitting the fight button or playing the fight card always, there's probably a lot of things in our marriage that would be helped if we would just get better at showing benign neglect to whatever would normally irritate us and recognizing that, you know, in the past that would have really bothered me, or in the past that would have really upset me, but I don't need to necessarily get over-focused on every little thing that somebody says or realize that, you know, your husband or wife are not always in a good mood. And when they're in a bad mood, they're going to act accordingly. And so we need to have more patience and grace and understanding for each other and recognize it's not that they hate me, it's just that they're in a bad mood. It's 100 degrees outside and the grocery store didn't, you know, bag the groceries for us. So no wonder this person's upset. No wonder this person is irritated. Or they were locked in a house all day with a bunch of crying toddlers. No wonder they're exhausted. And it's not that they're trying to be mean and angry. It's just they're at the end of their ability to tolerate whatever they're going through today. And instead of feeling attacked and hurt by their foul mood, I could support them and try to help them and encourage them. And the best way is just giving a little bit of extra grace and recognizing that it's been a hard day for this person. So what are we saying here today? Well, we're saying that you've got to make friendship the priority of your marriage. And then everything else sort of takes care of itself. So we've got to recover and set this as a priority for our relationship. And then watch the magic happen. You know, as I try to meet your needs and give more, you know, effort and initiative in meeting your needs, and you give more initiative in meeting my needs, as we develop this friendship, we truly do become partners, not just a married couple, but partners that share our dreams together, that share our hearts together. And this is what everybody wants. This is what everybody wants. But I think sometimes we just overcomplicate it. This kind of relationship is 100% possible. Now, you guys might need some help, okay? You just might need some help. And don't be afraid to reach out to somebody for marriage coaching or counseling or maybe a trusted pastor or whatever, or just a good friend who's been there that you trust that can relate to you and can understand and help you. But let me say this, you need to find somebody who is a friend to your marriage, not just a friend to you, because your friends don't want you to suffer. And I get that. I don't want you to suffer either, but a friend to your marriage will tell you maybe what you need to hear and not just what you want to hear to find relief. The best relief you can find is working to develop this kind of relationship together. And here's the point. Okay, let me just end with this. Somebody's got to start this. Somebody's got to start it. And I know you wish that you could just bring your husband to me and say, hey, Tom, fix my husband. I can't, okay? And you can't either. It's hard enough to try to work on and fix ourselves. We don't ever even really fix ourselves. But somebody's got to take the initiative. Somebody has to be first and say, okay, all right, you know, even though there might be some frustrations in the past, and even though I've got a lot of questions and a lot of, you know, somebody's got to take the initiative to decide where this marriage is headed. And you can definitely be that person. Doesn't matter whether you're, you know, the husband or the wife or the boyfriend or the girlfriend. It doesn't matter. It just matters. Well, wait, they're the assertive one. It doesn't matter. As soon as one of us changes how we relate, the whole relationship changes. And so you can make that decision today. And I just want to tell you, there is hope. There really is hope. There's hope for a better life and hope for a better marriage. And that's what we got to keep in mind. So there it is. Let's remember to treat our spouse with the same love, kindness, patience, understanding, excitement, enthusiasm. Treat them the same way we would any best friend or any great friend in our life. And watch your relationship begin to improve. Watch your romance threshold begin to improve. And everything will just start to get easier. And don't get discouraged if it takes a little bit of time. The other person might be resistant and they might be a little bit, you know, might get a little bit of pushback at first and it might feel awkward, but it's worth it 100%, okay? And realize that pushback is not because they don't want it. It's because they want it so desperately, but they're protecting themselves in case maybe it doesn't work well or you give up or you get frustrated with them. So if this video was helpful to you, please like the video, subscribe to the channel for more great information to change your life. And also put your comments in the comment section below. Tell us what you've done or what you're doing to improve the relationship or improve the friendship in your marriage. And as a couple of videos and playlists for you, if you want to get more information about how to have a better marriage, I got lots of videos on this topic, always working and thinking about how to improve our lives and our marriages. And as always, be present to life. I'll see you guys next time.